we worship thee. We thank you because you are the Lord. There is none like unto thee. Great Father in glory, we thank you for another gathering. Lord, the gathering of the saints.
Never fail. And when I
mention the name of Jesus, the name above every other name. Lord, every knee must bow. I see this young man. You are the shadow of yourself. Touch that eye that is bringing water. When you look at something for a very long time, the water will come out and your eye will be although you cannot see.
Lord of glory, as I show them the way,
Lord, you will bless them abundantly.
Yeah.
They are coming tomorrow with testimony.
Yeah.
Thank you, blessed Father. Speak to us tonight. In Jesus' name we pray.
Yeah.
You can have your seats. Turn with me to Exodus chapter 32. Reading from verse 1 through to verse 29. But because of our time, I am just going to take some of them. Exodus 32. I read from verse 1. And when the people saw that Moses delayed to come down out of the mount, the people gathered themselves together unto Aaron and said unto him, Up, make us God, which shall go before us. For as for this Moses, the man that brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we want not what is become of him. And Aaron said unto them, Break on the golden earrings, which are in the ears of your wives, of your sons, and of your daughters, and bring them unto me. And all the people break off the golden earrings, which were in their ears, and brought them unto Aaron. And he received them at their hands, and fashioning with a graven tool, after they had made it a molding calf. And they said, This be thy God, O Israel, which brought thee up out of the land of Egypt. And when Aaron saw it, he built an altar before it. And Aaron made proclamation and said, Tomorrow is a feast to the Lord. And they rose up early on the morrow and offered burnt offerings and brought peace offerings. And the people sat down to eat and to drink and rose up to play. And the Lord said unto Moses, Go, get thee down, for thy people, which thou broughtest out of the land of Egypt, have corrupted themselves. They have turned aside quickly out of the way which I commanded them. They have made them a molten calf, and have worshipped it, and have sacrificed thereon, and said, This be thy gods, O Israel, which have brought thee up out of the land of Egypt. And verse 21. And Moses said unto Aaron, What did these people unto thee, that thou hast brought so great a sin upon them? And Aaron said, Let not the anger of my Lord wax hot, thou knowest the people, that they are set on mischief. For they said unto me, Let all God, we shall go before us. For as for this Moses, the man that brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we want not what it become of him. Verse 25. And when Moses saw that the people were naked, for Aaron had made them naked, unto their shame among their enemies, then and there fell of the people that day about 3,000 men. For Moses had said, Consecrate yourself today to the Lord, even every man upon his son and upon his brother, that he may bestow upon you a blessing this day. Now, from the place we have read, the man Moses, whom God gave the charge. And when they now started walking on their way, They came to Aaron. The brother of Moses. Said, make us another God. They want to see the God that will lead us. For this Moses, they don't know what happened unto him. And Aaron made them a golden calf. And God being a jealous God, God saw that and became angry and announced to Moses, the people you brought, they have gone out of the way. They have gone aside from following me. And Moses came down and asked Aaron, what happened? Why did you now make the people to be naked? And then expose them before their enemies. And Aaron began to tell stories. And Moses now came and announced who is on the wrong side. Let him come. And only the tribe of Levi, out of the 12 tribe of Israel, they came to Moses. Moses said, take your sword, every one of you, and go against your brother. Now come near me. Consecrate yourself. In other words, dedicate yourself unto this God. And when you do that, God will bestow a blessing. Title, are you on the Lord's side? Are you on the Lord's side? Can you touch your neighbor by your side and say, neighbor, are you on the Lord's side?
The word of God made us to know that we are in the The
days when you don't know who is pursuing who, and the time that Christianity and religion is in total confusion.
And
the time that Jesus is about to come, the question is, are you on the Lord's side? Moses called for loyalty to God. Can you see that? Two categories of people. The children of God, the children of devil. Anybody that commits sin belongs to Satan. Anybody that does not commit sin belongs to God. Because the seed of God inside that person
will
not allow the person to sin. So, the choice you make in life determines what you are going to get and where you are going to be at the end of this life. It is either somebody go to heaven or hell. So, the people that serve God, when they die, they will go to heaven. But those that don't bother about God, when they die, they will go to hellfire, where Satan is. But it is not the will of God that any one of us here should go to hellfire. You are not going to go to hellfire. Make sure you will be on the Lord's side. Saw that the people, because of their sin, have have made themselves naked. You know, sin makes somebody to be naked. You will not have protection from God. The hand of God will be tied. The dangers, the thorns, the arrows by the devil, the witches and wizards, they will have power over that person. They will begin to press you. They will begin to urinate on you. They will begin to mess you up. You will be eating in the dream. You will be swimming in the dream. You will be flying. You will be committing immorality in the dream. You will see yourself carrying children in the dream. You will see yourself marrying in the dream. You will see yourself being pursued in the dream. When somebody is living in sin, you will be open. You will be naked. Satan will now walk on you. You will become his servant. You will become a servant. But we are saying, who is on the Lord's side? Who are those people? Pay attention. Those who choose to follow God must clearly separate themselves from wicked people and ungodly behavior. You want to follow God? You must separate yourself. That is the dedication we are talking about. You dedicate yourself unto God and separate yourself from the wicked man. Separate yourself from every ungodly life, like the people of Levi. Moses said, who is on the Lord's side? They separated themselves. And then Moses said, take your sword, begin to kill even your brothers, anybody you see that is not on the Lord's side. Don't spare the person. Those on the Lord's side are known by their godly lifestyle. Beginning with the response to the calling of the Lord. Isaiah 52 verse 11. Depart ye. Go ye out from them. Touch no unclean thing. Go ye out of the midst of her. Be ye clean that bear the vessels of the Lord. Joshua was one of them. On that day he prayed the children of Israel in Joshua 24, 15 and 16. He said, choose with me today whom you are going to serve. Is it the God that your forefathers served in any ways
today?
Is it the masquerade your fathers carried? Or the tradition of your forefathers? Choose this day whom you are going to serve. But for me and my family, we will serve the living God.
And
those that are on the Lord's side, they sacrifice their time. They sacrifice their money. They sacrifice their talent. They make themselves available for the work of God. They don't spare their time. When God is saying, I need you, they will not complain. They obey your authority. Those on the left side obey your authority. They commit themselves to the work of the Lord, both in the spiritual, both in the physical, both in the material and financial. Like Phinehas, the people that are on the Lord's side, they stand where God stood. They like what God likes. They hate what God hates. They do the work of God. They love the house of God. They honor the servants of the Lord. They go on to advance the kingdom of God. And they see God as their all in all. They only want to be honored. The only one that they will give their priority. And then they take care of God's people. These are those on the Lord's side. What are their blessings? God's covenant blessings for those on the Lord's side. In Exodus 32 verse 29. For Moses has said, consecrate yourself to them. To the Lord, even every man upon his son and upon his brother, that he may bestow upon you a blessing this day. Those that are on the Lord's side, there is a special blessing for them. God prepared a blessing for them. And through
Adam,
sin entered into the world. And every one of us, we are born in sin. And nobody is qualified to call God. And God search to know if there's anybody that is righteous. We didn't see anyone. And then he sent his only begotten son to come and die for our sin. And Jesus died the death you and I supposed to die. We're supposed to die for our sin. Then Jesus Christ went to the cross. The person that did not sin went to die for the sinners and carried our sin, that you and I might be free. So the person that is on the Lord's side, is that person that has done away with the sin, confessing and renouncing the sin, and hating that sin, and seeing it as sinful, then the blessing of God will come unto him. He said, blessed, fortunate, favor, to be envied, is that woman, is that sister, is that youth, that even say, and your name will be cancelled from the book of death. And your name be written in the book of life. You can call God Abba Father. You can pray and Jesus will answer you. You can call upon God and the Holy Ghost will come to lead you. God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost will come to live inside you, the person that is on the side of God. We have salvation. We have the privilege of communing with God. Another blessing, Psalm 91. From this world, anybody that is on the side of God, you will enjoy protection, you will enjoy preservation, you will enjoy deliverance. The angel of the Lord will be your security agent. What happened to other will not happen to you. What kill you that will not kill you? Because you are on the Lord's side. Psalm 91. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And we say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress, my God. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the noisome pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and under his wings shall thou trust. His throne shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid for the terror of thy land, nor by the arrow that flieth by death, nor for the pestilence that wandeth in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasted at noonday. A thousand shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but they shall not come near thee. Thou shalt tread upon the lion and adder. The young lion and the dragon shall thou trample under feet. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore will I deliver him. I will set him on high. Because I have known my name, he shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. That is the blessing, the covenant blessing for those on the Lord's side. They are like Elijah. When there was famine in the land, God sent Elijah to the brush and sent water to come and feed Elijah. Anybody that's on the left side, the whole others are saying and casting down. The person will be saying that lifting up. concerning Jesus Christ. And a voice came from heaven and said, Behold, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. In conclusion, looking at what it takes to be on the side of God, the question that is begging for an answer is this: Are you on the Lord's side? If your answer is no, you should take advantage of this golden opportunity to become one. God will take chariots to be on the side of Satan. But if the answer is yes, and you are sure through the exposition of this truth, I can tell such people congratulations. Then tell them to get ready for the open heaven. In all ramification, some people will now begin to enjoy what God has ordained for them. So are you on the Lord's side? I want you to check. Today, God wants us to dedicate our lives. Beloved, do you know there is a lot of troubles, killing, and many every time. A lot of insecurity. We are in a very dangerous time. If God did not keep you, our security agencies have failed us. They told us that everybody should now begin to defend himself or herself. But God that on the Lord's side, with the angel of the Lord, has been instructed to defend them. So are you on the Lord's side? But if you are not, you can now be one to them. So that by the time we are coming here tomorrow, by the time we are coming here tomorrow, you are going to enjoy God's blessing. You are going to eat to the fullest. We have come to dedicate this house. But the first and greatest house to be dedicated is your life. It's my life. We must dedicate our life unto God, telling God that we want to serve Him. We want to use the remaining of our life to do the will of God. If you are not on the Lord's side, you can rise to your feet and start stepping out. Come to the pulpit and give your life to Christ. Because the greatest thing that can happen to anybody is that somebody die without Jesus. We are seeing that a child of God is not a sinner. And a sinner is not a child of God. The people that have a tradition of their forefathers, and they are following the way of the world, they are not on the Lord's side. If they die, they will go to hell. For Jesus came to die so that we cannot go to hell. Shall we rise up, every one of
us? Can you have a book? Can you have a book?
The fountain of life, you flame in this place. Whosoever will,
shall have mercy.
On the Lord's side. you can step out to give your life to this Christ, to dedicate your life.
Oh,
you are born on the Lord's side, but along the way, you stray out, and you are no longer a child of God. You can step out. Because there is something that God said.
He
said, except a man be born again, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. So the Lord is inviting you to come and dedicate your life unto Him. So, whatever that is holding you, cut it off and say, Lord, I am here for you. Step out. I want you to face the altar. Oh, why not now? Why not now? Oh, why not now? Why not now? Why not come to Jesus Christ? Oh, my sister. Giving your life to Christ, I count too. sister begin to tell the Lord, you are a man. I want to look at that. And in your heart begin to tell prayer.
Congratulations.
tomorrow.
But you think I can have God and father?
I will wait for you tomorrow. Tomorrow, you come with your testimony. And make sure you invite somebody to this program. Because tomorrow is going to be a strange night. Tomorrow is going to be a strange night. Lord, that you will satisfy them. You will know them by their names. As their faces differ, that is how their matters and situations are. Lord, your word says you have not spoken in secret. Neither have thou spoken in dark places of the earth. You have not had the seed of Jacob to seek in there. Lord, this hand that is spread now, keep them, Lord, their heart desire.
Yeah.
I command divine favor upon your life.
Yeah.
And help.
Yeah.
Somebody will receive a gift tomorrow morning.
Yeah.
By somebody you need to respect. And your father.